Okay, and in 3, 2. In 3, 2, 1.
You can't do it.
No, now we can't do it. Okay.
He's like, what is this dude doing?
What's up, it's Reincarnate. We are live at the castle yet again on a Friday night. It is Friday, unlike last week when we were here Saturday night. I am here with the legendary Marcus, and I'm gonna butcher it because everybody else just Schossow, how do you turn up?
Schossow.
Schossow. Now you know exactly how to say it. A lot of people would just be saying Marcus in the interview because they don't know. And I don't care. I'm just gonna let's go. Are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah, well, so far really nice, yeah.
What time did you get here to Chicago?
I arrived here at 7 p.m., so it's cool.
How was your flight?
As always, long and just boring, you know.
Were you in Sweden? Did you come from Sweden? Or?
No, I came from Holland.
Okay. Yeah. I read in an interview that somebody had with you that you said that you wanted to just end up in a cottage with your girlfriend and just cook fish every once in a while.
Yeah.
Are you any closer to your goal?
Not yet. I still have to get the cottage and fish. But I actually just moved to Holland actually last week. And Holland is a center for all kinds of dance.
Oh yeah.
You know, so that's why I moved there, you know.
Okay. Well, people, like for me personally, I guess I'm kind of narrow-minded. I don't know. When you think of Sweden, I think of like Swiss chocolate, the Swiss Alps, blondes,
no, Sweden.
Watches.
Switzerland. No. There's two different countries. Switzerland is known for cows and banks.
Okay, what do you think of when you think of America?
Child bells. And Sweden is known for Zlatan, house music, mooses and snow, basically. Here we go. But what I think America is known for, I don't know, fast food. George Bush.
Oprah Winfrey,
sitcom, and Hollywood, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
I read also in an article that you said that you prefer to just be true to your sound and have a longevity in your career rather than just going with. There's so many songs now that you hear that build up and then they go into that epic, you know, that festival noise.
Yeah, I always try to make my stuff. Timeless, you know, because you know the trends always change, mm-hmm. And sometimes I don't like the trends, sometimes I really like it, so I cannot choose to have my own sound, you know, which doesn't really change too much, you know, too fast.
How old were you when you started?
I was about 13. My cousin was back then living in Miami. And
he sent you records.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then this friend of mine had this software and it was in school in like sixth grade. So, man, check this one out. And it was something called the Techno EJ, which is the most shittiest software ever produced, by the way. And
they'll be sending you your residual check in the mail, I'm sure.
Yeah, for sure they will. And I just, you know, I just sat there and played with it more and more and more. And literally, instead of playing video games, I made music.
It's a better yeah. outlet for you, more productive. Look where you are now.
Yeah, exactly.
If you could work with anybody in the industry, yeah. who would it be?
It would be a combo though, but probably
why not?
Charlie May, who is who did all the old such stuff, together with Trent Dumeller and James Holden. That would be really, really, really awesome. Yeah.
What's your favorite Trent Dumeller song?
It's called The Forest. It's absolutely amazing. It's outstanding. Really, really good track.
I always think of that Flashlights and Explosions song. That's the one that I really
enjoy.
That's the one that comes to mind for me. Do you have any new music you're going to be playing tonight?
I have one new song called Lusas, which did with Mike Hawkins and Pablo Riveros.
Have you played it anywhere else yet?
No.
Yeah.
Exclusive. And,
Castle exclusive.
Yeah. And it comes out the 9th of December by Size Records.
And where can people buy that?
Beatport, or just go to my Facebook or homepage.
Okay. You have any questions for me?
No, not really.
I have a question.
Yeah?
What's your shirt and your shirt say?
What?
What does your shirt say?
I don't know really.
Oh, I thought maybe it said your name or...
No, it's just something.
Okay.
Store. I didn't really...
Okay, I thought it was like your name and...
No, maybe it's just
Netherlands,
something like
neither.
Jeans is cool, I don't know. Whatever.
Okay, I just wanted to... That could be your shirt.
Don't worry.
I'll tell you the reason why she did that. I have some friends and they own a label. They own this clothing design and they're out of London. They're called Twisted Beak.
Okay.
Laidback Luke wears their stuff, and as of last week now, Hook and Sling is also going to be wearing it because I interviewed him and he liked it. So if you would be interested, we can have them send you some if you'd like their t-shirts.
Just do.
Awesome.
Well, I asked because Hook and Sling was wearing his shirt I asked him because his shirt was really cool. He's like, this is my shirt for my tour. And I'm like, that's cool.
Yeah, I never really wear my own t-shirts.
Okay.
Really, that's, yeah.
Yeah, they're too, too girly.
I don't know. It's
I don't know.
It's just like...
It's, they're fun.
I think people...
Sometimes.
Who comes to my shows knows who I am.
Sure.
So I probably don't need to wear a shirt.
You might as well wear a shirt that says that guy.
Yeah. You're here because of me, you know. So yeah.
Well, thank you so much for your time, man.
You're welcome, man.
Appreciate it. Look forward to dancing our asses off with you.
Yeah, for sure, man.
I'm Chris with EDM America TV, and we are here at the castle.
Peace out.